Seagrass meadows are the underwater backyard of Sarasota County. They add oxygen to the water and air, help the water stay clean and clear, and provide habitat for the marine creatures we love. Seagrass is all around us as we kayak, snorkel, fish, and dive. Thank you for volunteering to participate in the Seagrass Survey as a citizen scientist. The data you collect will help us better understand and protect this beautiful and complex ecosystem and our water quality. Let's take a few moments to go over the methods and tools you'll be using. There are two ways to conduct the survey: the provided data sheet or the mobile app. The data collection methods are the same for both. If using the app, you will need to install it on your device ahead of time. An email link will be sent to you, and clicking this link will open the app and take you to the Sarasota County Survey. To get you started, a map will be provided and you will be assigned hexagonal areas to visit. When you've reached your first area, it's time to begin the survey. Start by filling in your name, assign hexagon, and the time. Knowing where you collect your data is the most important part of the survey, so make sure to record your latitude and longitude. If using the app, clicking the locator button will automatically record your position. If using a data sheet, use the county-provided GPS or your boat's navigation system. Now it's time to get into the water. Remember, safety first. Avoid areas of high boat traffic. Anytime you're in the water, your dive flag must be displayed, and make sure your vessel is equipped with personal flotation devices. You will begin by using the PVC pole to mark the survey center point and measure the water depth in meters, with each hash mark representing 1/10 of a meter. If you can see clearly to the bottom, indicate it on your survey. If you can't, use the Secchi disc to gauge the visibility. Lower the disc slowly into the water and stop when it is no longer visible. The hash marks on the string will indicate the depth. Next, identify the sediment type. There are three: sand, muck, or a sand shell combination. Now, with the PVC pole still marking the center point, swim out and begin your rapid assessment of the survey radius using your snorkel mask or aquascope. Remember, it's impossible to count every blade of grass. Focus on the big picture and use your best estimate. Be thorough, but don't spend too much time at one point. Estimate what percentage of the bottom is covered in seagrass. As seagrass may be in clumps, you'll have to use your best guess as to what percentage of the radius is covered. There are four species of seagrass. Identify which comprise the grass-covered area within the survey radius. Turtle grass is flat and wide like a fettuccine noodle. Manatee grass is long and cylindrical like a spaghetti noodle. Shoal grass is flat and narrow and grows mostly in shallow water. Paddle grass is branched and has a leaf or paddle on the end. Even though only a small percentage of your area may be covered, the species percentage should add up to 100. For example, if half the grass present is turtle grass and half the grass present is shoal grass, you would put 50% for each. Remember, use your best estimate. Use the provided measuring tape to gauge the height of a representative blade of grass from each present species. Now, let's look for algae. Epiphytes are algae that grow symbiotically on seagrass. Assess and record the presence and abundance ranging from clean to extreme. Next, we'll look for algae that isn't attached to seagrass. Drift algae resembles tumbleweed and doesn't have roots. Rooted algae will be growing from the bottom. Be sure to record any notable sea life. If you can safely take a picture, do so with your personal camera or using the feature in the app. Your survey is now complete. Double-check your data, making sure you used proper units of measurement and completed all fields, even if the answer is zero. Thank you for your contribution as a citizen scientist today and a steward of the Bay for a lifetime.